If you're new to our channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button.
So we have late blight, and that's a word that gardeners cringe at the thought of. Late blight is an air-distributed spore that affects your tomato plants. It does affect potatoes as well. What the perfect conditions for late blight are: moist, cool conditions. That's what we've had for the last couple of weeks, and this has infected one of, and I've seen it affect other patches of tomatoes. Your sign of late blight is the leaves begin to get discolored, your stalks get discolored and blackened in portions, and then you'll also see your fruit, which now is, even if it's ripe, it's inedible, it gets affected with this very unpleasant mess here. So what can you do to protect yourself from late blight? Well, it's really difficult to protect yourself from late blight since it's an air distributed spore, unless you're in like a greenhouse. One thing you can do is once you see late blight, you can apply a copper fungicide. Now, this is not going to stop late blight. This will slow it down by experts' recommendations. The preferred method of getting rid of late blight is just getting rid of the plant. You can burn these plants, but also you want to be careful because if you're in a community garden, an allotment, neighboring gardens at your residence, those spores can be transferred through the particles that go up in the air. Ideally, you would want to take and put this stuff in your trash, or if you're living on a homestead or a place where you have somewhere you can dump it, just dump it as far away from your growing location as possible. You don't want to compost this. You definitely don't want to put this in the road gutter or in front of the house for local municipality pickup, even though they want you to, and they don't want you to put it in your local municipal trash. The reason why you don't want to put it in the street is the same reason why you don't want to put it in your compost pile. You're going to have the city pick it up. It's a diseased plant. They're going to take it to their facility, compost it, and then everybody in the city is going to go back, or many people will go back and pick up that fresh compost the next growing season that contain the spores of late blight, or can potentially contain the spores of late blight. So the best scenario here, the best situation, is to rip it up, put it in bags, put it in your municipal trash so it looks like trash. And you want to be very careful when handling this, because the spores, especially if you've got other plants, if this is early in the season or later on like we are, this can spread on your clothing. If you have your hands dirty, you touch another plant from when you're harvesting those ripe tomatoes, it can spread that way. So you want to be very careful with this, and especially dragging it through the garden, community garden, allotment, that type of thing. So we've got issues here, and what you want to do here, we're going to take the strings, we're going to take everything. Normally we save the strings for these trellises here, and we'll use them again. With this instance, we're going to take everything and get rid of it. The only thing we're going to save here is the metal post, and we're going to wipe them down with a bleach solution with the hopes of making sure that they don't contain any late blight spores that can be spread next year's growing season. Late blight is nothing resembles late blight. It's not comparable to early blight. Early blight is a fungus in the soil that splashes up on your plants that affects the leaves but doesn't affect the fruit. And it can kill your plant, but there's ways of slowing it down, removing it, the early blight. With late blight, once you have it, there's no way of scientifically removing it. There's a way of slowing down, like I talked about. So we'll come in here, we'll remove all of this, bag it up, be careful, put it in the municipality trash, and then we're done with the tomatoes. And I have seen it can spread here. I've seen it in other patches. So late blight's not a disease that I would hope on you, but with this information, at least if you have it or might get it, you will now know what it is, what to look for, and how to fix the problem.
For more information, please visit thewisconsinvegetablegardener.com.